Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this extraordinary event for Lithuania, and especially those of us who are interested in architecture and built environment. I am Andrius Jurelionis. I'm the Dean of the Faculty of Civil Engineering and Architecture in Kaunas University of Technology. And today, together with Gintaras Balčytis and Ingrida Povilaitienė, the colleagues of mine and architects, we are having a discussion and an open lecture of world-renowned architect Massimiliano Fuksas. Massimiliano Fuksas is co-founder, together with his partner, Doriana, of Studio Fuksas, and with their head office in Rome and offices in Paris and Shenzhen and Dubai, with over 600 projects in their portfolio. Massimiliano Fuksas is the winner of numerous prestigious awards and for his inspiring and iconic designs. Mr. Fuksas has always emphasized that he's of Lithuanian descent, and we were really excited to learn that at the end of 2021, that Lithuanian citizenship was restored to him. So this is a really, really important event for us. To have you, Massimiliano, with us. Welcome virtually to Kaunas.
Thank you very much, indeed. Now, I said the first project I want to show you is this one. Can you show? This is my project of passport, Lithuanian passport. Then we got a passport 1 month ago, 2 months ago. We are very proud to have this. It's for my father and for all my family. Thank you. We can go on. Then, now that it's organized, we can start with a few projects that is some images of the, it's a mostly video to see what we are doing. It's better to understand video. This is the day of opening of the Shenzhen airport in China. And this is one of the huge projects that we did, like, you know, some others like Los Angeles or Italy in trade fair in Milan or something like this. This was very exciting to work. In 3 years, we built this one. This was a real pleasure because it was a way to understand better one country that we discovered many years before, in 92. In 92, we started to work for a project in Pudong. The project with the master plan, we are invited with some friends, and Richard Roger was the one of my best friends that was invited with me for this project then. The video is only the way that we have to show real projects because we are a little bit tired of seeing always images of this is the life of to every day. Only things that I can do in this project, we utilize about 90 algorithms, different algorithms. Because all the ceiling is so complex that now we have no time to explain. That is the way to realize this in the better way. The algorithm help us to find with the parametric, of course, project structure, we could work in a better way. Can you go? Then we are another project here. A small one is the last we are doing now in the Black Sea. It's quite finished now. In a few days it will be finished. It's an airport. This is the biggest, huge airport that we did, and this is very small. And this is interesting for us because all the roof, inside of the roof, we had a different algorithm that we organize better the light that fell inside. I think that it's clear for you, yes. Okay. You want. Yes, this is the way now, it's quite finished. The roof, the ceiling is a really complex. It is a triangulation. It's not only triangulation, it's the better way to see like a drop, a map that is moving, is changing, give you a dynamic space. Okay. Now this is the last in China, in Shenzhen, we built a few towers. This is the last one that we built, Guosen Tower. What is interesting in this project is not only the shape, but the way in which we, the sustainability is very important. With this cut, we can, with this gap, we can organize, reorganize, reutilize for three times the air conditioner, the fresh air, and something else. Now, what I love is the greenery that we are in all our projects. The greenery is the way in which we explain better what really we need. We need to have always some space in which people can have a better way to live, a better life. And now it's quite finished. Now it's this. There are another two towers that we are in the end of this project. This is a very strong sculpture. This is for living, housing, and the other one is office, of course. This one is office, and the other is a living house. This is the project that we are in Roma. We built in Roma in the last years. The name is The Cloud. Every people call this The Cloud. This is the building site. We built this 8 years. And this was some image of the building site and the construction. That is very exciting because you can understand better the way in which is working, in which way the construction is done. This is what is the convention hall for 1,085 people, seats, that they can use this, they use this for all the events. For music, because it's, the acoustic is, by the chance, is very good. The height of this space, void, is about 50 meters high. When you arrive from a distance, one staircase, and after you arrive in this big space, you have a really an impression of open eyes. It's so huge, it's so strong space that you are much better inside. And after you come inside our second piazza, this is the place in which you are under the cloud. And the cloud is this space with auditorium of eight, like I said, 1,800 and more seats. You change all my projects. We are it's works because you change the height from a very low, lower space, you have a very huge space. And after this variation give you in a, you know, like you say, one impression, you are impressed with the space. I hope, almost. This was a few years before the construction that we did in Fiera di Milano. In Fiera di Milano, a trade fair in Milan, is about, altogether is 1 million square meters that we built in 26 months. And the central axis, the central street, the road, is about exactly 1 mile. This is the way which you use, because the metro arrive exactly in the beginning of this promenade. This is, you can see that it's like a skyline, because it's face this project, face the Alps, the mountains. When you are in ground floor, you have the perception of this change in space. In the same period, we build a project that now is fantastic. This project is Nardini, is done in Bassano del Grappa near Venice for Grappa Nardini. It's a laboratory, but it's also in July every year is a performance space that they use this space for contemporary dance. And then is the best way to explain that our approach is done not only to do architecture, but to do the space for everything. It's flexibility, it's space that we can give to everybody for everything. In the ground floor, there are theaters for symphony, for music. But Ferrari was quite the same, because when we built the Ferrari, the Ferrari laboratory and the lab in Maranello. The idea of project is to have on the second floor one lake with water. And the water was for sustainability, for a better climb inside, a better condition of living. And then we built this in, it was mostly fast, this building. You can see, you discover you from outside to interior, you discover one world. Yes, you can see there are three levels, and all together they give a very, very funny place. Really, the people that are working there, they are so happy, they live well, they tell me. This is the best and most important for an architect. And after they are, it's not only this, in this project, there are even the cantilever is about 25 meters, the cantilever, that perhaps you can see in some place, I don't know. Because the people are living there, are working there for days and days and months. And then you have to give a space, a connection that is not only sustainable, but even fun. You have to have some fun when you have one building. Okay. Then this is what we are now just finishing in Naples. It's one station on metro, that we are quite finished, but it was very complicated. We take 20 years to build because we discovered inside, under, more than inside, one temple of first century. And this temple was for Olympic Games. You know, in Naples, they had the Olympic Games, even like in Olympia. That we want the archaeology is part of our project, is part of the buildings. This is the temple. Yeah. This is the basement of the temple. We are now some corpse that we have to stand up. But this is the interior of the station when you are coming inside the station. Now in function, it's very strange. We can change colors, light. It's like we can play with light, with different colors. It's to play, to give in this period when you are in the station, you are always running, and then it's too late. And then this gives you a more funny space. Then a few years ago, Giorgio Armani, that is the best friend of Doriana, asked us to organize to rebuild them in New York, Fifth Avenue, with the 57, one space for his Armani in New York, Fifth Avenue. Then there is one second that said, no, there is no one point that touch the wall, but it's only one point. This case touch only one point, the ground. And it's something quite dramatic. It's a tremendous when you are inside because you don't want to take the elevator because it's so nice to be in this circuit. They take a lot of pictures, they stay there, they meet people, they are speaking with their friends and some other people. And on the inside, we have a restaurant, of course, we have facilities, we have our money. But this was very complex to do this. We built this in Roma, not in Roma, in Italy. And we moved from Italy to New York. We shipped this, all the staircase, we cut in different parts, and we moved in New York. Because it was so complicated to build this in New York, that it was much better to build in Italy. It was quite no common, nothing so easy, but it was different. You can see that this was cut in I don't know how many parts and shipped all. Even in Armani, in Tokyo, we build this. My main important Armani in Tokyo Giza Tower. We build a small tower for Armani, not so small, but a tower. But all these are experiences that you see how much it's nice to work with others, to have a relationship with the client, even the people. To have always an investigation of what is happening really in one city in some way. Of course, we designed with Doriana all the interior, all the frame that you can see. Yeah, this is another chapter of our life. Because we build in the central Eindhoven in Holland, we rebuild the central of our city, great part, and even one building that everybody can call this the blob. In this blob, they used to, in the summertime, like you can see in Nardini, use the light, it's like a screen, art screen, art installation. In many of our projects, they become art installation after a few years. And this is with the Philips. Every year they are doing, they are using this, and this is changing. It's so funny, but so interesting to give some space. Then we give one building that is not only building, it's some surface that in which they can put all the ideas, the creation. This can change, you can see all what happened in the nature, you can see in this surface. Then, a few years ago, we built in one concert hall. This is very, very, very huge project for even for pop art, for pop music, about 11,000 sets. It's a complex because we start from concrete inside, and after we put some steel in the merge in the periphery, and after the final touch is not far from Strasbourg in Germany, gone. In Germany, in Frankfurt, we build a shopping center that is a little bit more than a shopping center. You can see, gone. It's like a landscape. This we built this many, many years ago, I think about 20 years ago, something like this. And this is the last floor, in which there are many restaurants, many ways to live. It's still going on very well because you see in this building, there are no columns quite. Everything is suspended. Is like flexible and maximum flexibility. In quite all our buildings, there is a few columns, quite nothing. And this is one of the last projects that we did in Sofia for the central area, the piazza. Svedaneleja Platz. Now we have finished the project. The end of this year, so they start to build. It's the connection between many things, pedestrian, tramway, all the area, archaeological area, historical area. It's so complex. But it's even very exciting to work in this project. Because green is a part of the project, but it's not only green water, it's green water but even the possibility to give to do some play that every people can meet, stay together. It's a common space. This is exactly the perimeter of the project, the border of the space. We are very involved in the central area of the project that is historical project. We did the same for Roma too. And we try, of course, to change the city, mostly for pedestrians. This is a Roman city with the Cardo and the Cumano, the main axis. And they have, is evident the Cardo with all historical part of the ruins. A lot of this space in Soviet period, they destroyed. The transformation of the city in mostly in greenery and sustainability, and even a different kind of light, a different furniture for the city. This is one of the most important that we are doing always. This is only a few things that we want to show you, but we want to finalize our presentation with this project. That is a project that we want, it's a project for the future. I think that when you have a lot of main street, autobahn, main roads, and that you have no space, then we call this urban quantum. Then we can cover this, change this in greenery, to have a part of city, connect this with the river, with the city, this is in Seoul. Or you can you organize all this, but there is something else that is possible to reorganize and utilize CO2 and change this in some performing space. This is the algorithm is an interesting algorithm because it's a cellular algorithm that change quite automatic. The effect that even one cell can eliminate the other that is ill, sick, they are not so good, are not for sustainability. Then it's quite automatic the way in which the shape and the organization of the space become. And after, if you can see now all the system that with the street, with the roads, with the cars, they can use the CO2, can put in one, can have a storage for CO2, reutilize for different scope. And after you can have even the street can be something that you can use like performing electrical system. It's a new system that there is many, many copyright for this one. This is our only a few projects that we want to share with you to see what we are doing. It's always researching. It's quite 50 years that we are doing every day we are working for this. And after, I think that is the only funny way to go on. Thank you very much. I try to give you like a summary of what we are doing.
Thank you very much. That was truly amazing and inspiring. So we can move to the discussion and questions and answers session. I have already questions coming in from the audience and from students, I believe, from some questions.
I am watching behind you and the project that now we are doing in Monte Carlo.
Okay, the one behind us. Yes. All right.
This is a huge project because with this project, it's very interesting for us, for our office. You know, we try to reorganize and heal the urban space, the nature that it was, and after they destroyed it. Now we want to reorganize this exactly like what it was. But we can use this to build another building. Some other buildings, some more. Sorry.
yeah, that's yeah, I saw that you didn't talk about this project, but we found it really interesting and inspiring. I have a couple of questions that also I wanted to ask, and I see that the audience is asking that question, basically about the whole flow of your creative process. You mentioned before about the importance of light and about this screenplay or the story that you design for the building. And the audience is also asking, do you usually start with form or function? And basically, how is your creative process going with all these projects?
I don't know if I try to understand what my process, because I don't know. Perhaps in a few years I will know. But is the best is to never, for me, is the best is forget all the process, because it's a non-logical process. Architecture is something crazy. We can call this in Italy, we are matti. We are a little bit matti, how do you say, mad. Because if you do this kind of a profession or works, you have to be really mad. It's quite, but otherwise there is no solution. There is no money, no for people that will give you all the pleasure, all the honors. It's really crazy because every day for all your life you have to fight for something that you don't know. But what is creation for me? Creation is when you are sleeping in the night, about 5-6 o'clock in the morning, that you are not really, you are not awake, you are not sleeping. And that's the moment you see, you touch the project. You are blind, you are shut the eyes, and you see. And when you can build with your fantasy, with your imagination, with your mind, something without doing any drawings, you start to understand what is architecture. Architecture is completely, completely untouchable, invisible. But it's visible and you can build. But you have to do something that you don't know. You have to convince your client that he doesn't know anything, and you doesn't know the project. You can explain him something that you don't know. You try to explain with something that you don't know at all. But this is the way in which you are always near to buildings. What I don't like is when people copy too much each other. You can see all the social Facebook, Instagram, people are doing projects with Instagram now. And this I don't like. You know, there are no imagination. They are copy. And now we are tired to see always the same project. It's never changed. Sometime happened. I think I wish to try to fight, to take a risk. Can you understand this? Take a risk. It's English, it's take a risk. For the young people, take a risk, every risk. When something is difficult, do it. When it's impossible, do twice it.
Okay. All right. So I will also use this opportunity to introduce the audience to my co-panelists. So Gintaras Balčytis is a well-known Lithuanian architect, the winner of the National Culture and Art Prize, and he's also the founder and curator of the Kaunas Architectural Festival. And Ingrida Povilaitienė is a PhD in the theory and arts, and she's also a teacher in our faculty. So please, Gintaras, shoot whatever question you have.
Okay. Thank you for your lecture. It was amazing. And actually, at the beginning, you said that the most important project was to get Lithuanian passport. But actually, you made some proposals also in Lithuania. I have some figures here. At 2005, you made proposal for Vilnius Concert and Sports Hall and Žalgiris Stadium reconstruction. Also for Guggenheim Vilnius at 2007. Office building contest in 2016, and actually at 2003, I think you was in Lithuania the first time as a chair of international jury of Lithuanian exhibition of architecture introspection. And actually, why I'm talking about this one, because I got a main award of exhibition from your hands, actually for Kaunas military barracks reconstruction. So,
but I remember perfectly.
Yeah.
I remember, of course.
Okay, so Mike, I would like to ask you about Biennale in Venice. And in 2000, you was a director of Biennale of Venice with the title "Less Aesthetic, More Ethic." So, and actually, maybe this idea was more tied to the speed of very huge scale urban intervention in the whole world. Do you think your topic is still actual at nowadays?
Thank you very much for this question. Now it's much more. When I added the idea of the vision of this title for Biennale was 2 years before 2000, in 1998. And because I was thinking that now is period that we have to give our help for the city, for the people, for the human being, to be more free, but even, what is it? Ethics is things that we cannot live in a world that is a few is exactly this as the number. 1,200 people, they are rich, almost quite 4 billion of people. This is what is laissez-faire moralities. You cannot have one society this way. It's quite impossible. One day or another we'll finish this. Because it's the energy, the consumption. We are not now in a condition that we can destroy more this planet. In Venice, if you have been there, we build one wall of 300 meters that was with a very, not a very performing system, it was with 36 projectors that make in the screen that all what's happened, even the dramatic immigration, was everything was inside with the different, with the problem of the abundance, everything, the trust, everything was the world, the best things in the world. The problem of the water, the problem of desert, the problem of immigration. In this screen, we move all these people. For this, because we don't want to destroy the aesthetics. We want only to now, it's 22 years ago, quite 25 years ago, we want to put the finger in the very complex situation and difficulties for all the human beings. This is what's happened there.
All right, thank you.
Hello, it's very nice to be here and to hear your presentation. It's really inspiring, and I have several questions, but I will start from the first one. Right now, maybe just continue the topic. Today in the morning, we had a meeting with Lithuanian pupils, and we were talking about climate change, and we were proposing like some kind of architectural solutions that could be implemented. And really, I liked your idea that in your several projects, you have really, you have those solutions implemented, this challenge, like our CO2 emissions, and your final project also is related, really related to all those challenges. How architecture actually can help people sometimes even unconsciously, like you're in your money building, yes, that the staircase is so beautiful that people just want to walk, and they will be healthy just because they are climbing those stairs. How are your ideas, how that architecture can help even for people who usually do not think about those problems, or they are not like sure about those problems?
Yes, it's very intelligent what you say. It's clever, because we are living every day in this very difficult situation. But we don't know, and we go on. We are pandemia, and we go on. It's 2 years of pandemia, we stay home, we are working with the mask, we go on. Then I think that the human being is so strong, is so crazy that we can go on. But what can do an architect? The architect can do what they can do. They have to give the better condition to live. It's a better life. This is the most important. What is a better life? That is, was the city has to be it's more relaxing, more happy. The greenery is something that you live with. The sky is blue like today. The pollution has to be less. Something very simple. And after we have to have a circular economy, you have to know everything that in our project, there are many, many materials that we utilize. But we don't say, I don't want to emphasize too much about what we are doing. We do exactly what we think every day is the best. Now we are working in Saudi Arabia. We are working mostly about hydrogen city. I am working now with my colleagues, my team, to see what we can do for hydrogen city. It seems that one, the energy of hydrogen is much more interesting and much more common. But to do this, we need a lot of energy. But this energy we cannot have from the normal way. Otherwise, we go on with the structure of our planet. But we can use solar system and some other system. That with in Saudi Arabia, there is a fantastic climate. We can use all the sun. And we can utilize this to give it the energy to start to cut the two molecules of hydrogen, H2O, H2O. You have to cut this. This you need a lot of energy. Then you have the energy, but you have to take the energy where you have, because hydrogen is fantastic. If you utilize the sun, then it's from 200 that we need, you have only 20. It's something that you can have, can be easy, complex, but can be a lot of you have to think for the future. This is what happened for the Arc. Like in 2000, I was thinking to have an exhibition with the future for the people that are young people, people that was not well known, but they are now well known, they go on, and now they are old, these young guys, but they are very good. Thank you very much for the question.
I think I can read a couple of questions from the list here, because it links to what you've said, because a couple of people are asking what are the features of good architecture, and what do you give the most attention to during your design? So as you were talking about sustainability, maybe that's becoming something that you can use as a measure for good architecture. What would you list as features of good architecture?
Life. This is there is always a gap, but it's the life, what we are looking for. The life is everything inside. There is the space, the history, architecture, the water, the two fire again, the new, so it's everything in the life. Life is living. And this is the best for an artist, for us. We love the life. We are loved so much as well that we cannot do anything else. We are so crazy to go on.
All right, thank you.
And you know, you mentioned the life, but is the life different in different parts of the world? You know, how we live in the global world, more or less, yes. But different places has different identities, and is the quality of life slightly different in different places? And should it be different? And aesthetic should be different in different places?
We are working overall in the world, not overall, but quite. I think the light and light, we can use these two words. Light is like Shenzhen, I tell you. Shenzhen, we are natural light, an airport with natural light. Why? Because it's a subtropical climate in China, in Shenzhen. Then we can use this like a screen. All this light is light. Then this life is something different. Everybody lives a different life. But the difference is a richness. I cannot imagine that everybody is thinking the same, are living the same life, are all the same, are eat everything the same. I don't like. I like the multiplicity of what we can. I want to go in one restaurant in Vilnius or in Kaunas, where you like, to eat something that I have not used to eat in Roma. And this is the difference, is even for everything, so for a biotopic. Biotopic is the most important we have, because we are losing many animals, many plants, many vegetables. And this is the multiplicity of this is the richness. This is what I want, that there are many, many multiplicities. Sorry.
Yeah, actually, all those beautiful buildings, they are nice, everybody likes them, but they are bloody expensive. And now we have the new course, we call it the New European Bauhaus, with some ideas that fits to equality for all, sustainability. What do you think, what is the future of Europe and architecture?
But it's the problem is before is Europe. What is the future of Europe? It's very difficult. But I am not a pessimist, because if I was pessimist, I could not be an architect. If we are thinking that the people that won the war are much stronger than the people that does want the war, it is not for architecture. An architect is always optimist. Otherwise, there is no reason to be an architect. If we are thinking that we will die, not die in other sense, our planet, because every day the man is so intelligent, so crazy, stupid, but intelligent too, that can discover something else. Yesterday they did an experiment in UK with Italian too, that was for the new system of a nuclear system. We can see green, blue, green nuclear, because they did an explosion of like one star. And this was done in one very small system, machine, and laboratory. That we are doing our ways. We are so crazy. Now we have a problem that we have no more energy. We have no more gas, anything. But there is something else. Everybody go on to think something new. Because we want to go on. Even if we did a lot of wars, a lot of crazy things. The human being had a lot of pandemia. Now we are 8 billion, always, more and more. It means that we are so more stronger than we believe.
Yeah, that's an optimistic thought indeed.
We are 8 million, billions.
Yeah.
It's a lot.
We can do something. I have a. I believe from the question list, there is a question. From student, how can they be hired by Studio Fuksas? And any tips for students that would like to, come for you for traineeship or be hired by?
Give me some money. No, it's a joke. It's a joke. No, we had some trainer. We had a few Lithuanians in our office for many years. one worker with me in the, just in the building that you see behind you, that was Shenzhen. This is he's still a good friend of mine. Now he's in New York, but he's a very good friend of mine too. He's worked here for a few years. But there are always some Lithuanian. It's open for Lithuanian. It's always open door. I don't know why, but it's open door.
All right. Anything can possible.
Anything. Right.
Can you mention a couple of projects of yours that you are most proud of? This is also the question from the list.
At the next one, too. The next one.
Okay.
Yeah, it's always this. If you are proud of something, you stop. You go in to take, you go in the one island in Antille. You go there, you sleep there, and after you died. The best is that the next project is the best.
All right, thank you. Please, colleagues.
But it's true, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, so I wanted to, again to ask about architect today, as I hear from you, is not really only the artist, yes? You need to know a lot of technical details, yes? Or at least to have a general understanding of those technical things and then get the support from the outside, yes? So how to balance between the uniqueness like an artist, yes? And the teamwork, like you need to always work with the team. How you balance those things?
No, there is no balance, because you are very, it's very clever, this question too. Sorry for you, very clever, too much clever. But the women are always very, it's terrible, very good. And I think, I trust that you have not to emphasize too much technology. You have not to emphasize. You use like a car. What do you do with the car? You open the car with the key. Now open the car, you go inside. After you start. You don't think every moment what is inside of the machine in which it works, that you are not looking the engine of the car. You are going with the car. This is the way that you know that it's complex. You know everything about this. You try to have more information as possible, but you don't emphasize. It's something in which we stay with you. The technical technique is stay with you. I know that there is 80, 90 algorithm. I don't know. I know if you want. I don't know all. I know that we use algorithm. We use another system that is, now we love a lot this system, cellular automata. It's an algorithm, it's a, because you can close one space and the space will, this you know, but you have to wait to make the boundary. You see what you can do. You don't see all the system, otherwise you become crazy. See all the detail. You pass your life to see all the detail. We use the detail. I know the detail. I tell you something. In my office, I am the best for the staircase, for the toilet. I am the best to do toilet and staircase, because these two are the most difficult things for an athlete. And when I see they are many difficulties, I will do for them. But without emphasizing to my 2D how much I am intelligent, clever, I do toilet, like a toilet. I know in which way we have to do a toilet and the door, in which way, like, not only toilet, this, But even everything that you need, like staircase, I say, is always the most difficult part of a building. When you are in the ground floor, you want to go up. This is something crazy, very clever to do this, to find a way, to translate this in architecture, to give to the staircase something that the staircase has not. Staircase is a stupid staircase. But you want to do with the staircase something that give you more irony, intelligent, clever, fantasy, creativity, yeah, to discover the space, to discover from when you are low to when you go up. This is in two different situations. You have something else, something more for you. This is a moment, a difficult moment. Difficult, fantastic, crazy thing, moment. It was good, it's clear.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, that's also links to another question. How do you cooperate with structural engineers? Do you have structural engineers in your team? Or do you have, you know, collaborators as structural?
As to know in which way you can build. If you don't know in which way you can build, you can ask to everybody, when you give to some engineers always, we have just done the project. It's not a structural engineer that is doing the project. It's the architect that is doing the project. For this the reason, architecture and structure are the same things. Sometimes I had some stupid engineers, so sometimes very intelligent indeed. The stupid one tell me, I need 16 columns. And I say, no, I can give you only 6. And one good one say, I don't need the columns. He's a good engineer.
Okay. Right? No questions?
Okay, because our audience, we have a lot of students, so it's a question maybe. I don't know how many, it's a lot. But the question is about education. What do you think about architectural education? Is it important or not? Because, you know, we know a lot of architects, they had not architectural education at all, like Tadao Ando or Le Corbusier or you. Is it important? Because it might be, if you have some artistic ideas and something, is it possible to be an architect without education nowadays?
Yes. No, yes. I can give you one something about my life, I say, part of my life. I didn't want to be an artist. I want to be an artist. This is the first. And after, because my mother, she said, you are crazy. I said, you are crazy. An artist is terrible. I see your catastrophe behind you is terrible. An artist, I was living very well. I was 18 years old. I was making nice design. I was before, I had been 2 years with Giorgio De Chirico. It was nice. I didn't want, but after she said, what do you want to do after school, high school? I said, well, nothing, painter. She said, no, tell me something. He said, philosophy? Say no. She was professor of philosophy. I said, architecture? Ah, it's okay. And after I spent for 5 years, I said, now I have to do all the examination very fast. In 2 years, I did everything, but I didn't like anything. I was really like an animal. I had no information about architecture. I did all examination. And after, one day I was I was always drawing, painting, something like this. I was in London, student, young guy. I was working in one restaurant like every young people like me in that time. And I met a friend of mine. He told me, but you are a student of architecture. There is one strange guy, people that are doing in one garage there. This could be something that you can like. You could like. And after I went there, I met a lot of people making models, strange models, so they make collage or something like this, but very crazy. Or science fiction was something like this. And after I say something, I can work here. Yes, okay, I don't pay you, but you can work here. What? Something. I pay them to do a model, so something. Go there. And I started. Was Archigram. You know Archigram. It was Archie. This guy was Ron Aaron. And other guys was my friend Peter Cook. And now we are very good friends, of course, with Peter Cook. Then after I discovered, he said, now this I like. This is amazing. The other was not very intelligent. Then from that time, I start to do something small, and after I was in some office, I was in Hudson project office when he was in Copenhagen for doing the project in Australia, in Sydney, and after I was in for a few months with Ian Larsen, and I start to understand what's happened. You smell. These are the most important, to smell. And to do something that is crazy. This was the opposite of school. That's the people of Archia was everybody was against them.
All right. I have a question which maybe links a bit to the artistic side of architecture. Please listen carefully. Whenever I talk to an architect, I get the feeling that life is straightforward, simple, and natural to them. My overcomplicated point of view can't match theirs. Is it due to their heightened sensitivity to nature, environment, light, or darkness?
I think yes, it's very interesting. But the problem is this, that I don't want to tell to the young guys, oh, architecture is terrible. You have an awful client, people that ask you something that you like. This is awful. You have to tell them architecture is happiness. You can be part of this. But only one thing from you. You have been 50% artist, creativity, 50% of necessity. You put together something you can. No, something can happen. But you cannot say, please, don't do because it's terrible, there is the war, you cannot work. No, there are many people that have been in my office, they are very successful. There are many people that are working in China, in Australia, I don't know where. They are very successful, they do very good projects. There are many young people that not only young, there is many people that are doing a nice project, intelligent project.
So would you say that architects are more mindful than other people or not really?
No. It's like un artigiano intelligente, arts and craft, intelligence, arts and craft. My intelligence is intelligent mind, is artificial intelligence. It's an artificial intelligence as a craft. Okay. You do by the end, it's also you work with artificial intelligence.
But an architect have to be explorer, basically, yes? You need to explore the world. And how much traveling and getting to know other peoples and other countries is important? Maybe an architect, a successful architect, first have to be a nomadic person. You need a little bit to travel, to see what's going on, not just to stay in your own shell.
The best period of my life was the worst period, that was the last 2 years. I was in the first years I was in the countryside in Siena, and another part of the years I was in Pantelleria, one island that we have a house there. It was the best part of this period because we had many exchanges with everybody by Zoom, by this system. We share a lot of experience, and we organize a team. We discovered something that I never understood really till deep, till how much it was deep. We cannot work, I could not work, I cannot work without multidisciplinary. I need the others. And perhaps the others need me. If we need others, this is the best way to start. To understand that you can work together. And after, when you are in this system that we are speaking with a lot of people now, it's not so bad. You have not to travel. I spend all my life traveling. But now I am thinking, how much, why I was so stupid to travel. Now I have to go I don't know where, in Galesi to see, to have the opening of my airport. But I could not, I could stay, even I could stay here, home. Because he said, no, we have a many relationship with over all the world. You are in my heart, I feel you here. It's not that we have only, it's better if we touch, we see each other, we share the hands, something like we embrace, it's fantastic. But the spirit was not so bad.
Thank you.
You also mentioned in a sneak peek before this presentation about the changing cities after the pandemic. And can you elaborate a bit your thoughts on how cities will change and what do you believe change is needed for cities after we go out of this pandemic?
The first things that we did with Doriana, when we start to this period last years, was to write a letter to the President of the Republic in Italy. Because we want to tell him only this, that it was the most important was the concept of hospital, the concept of what is the protection of the people, the protection of the old people, something like this. And after we discovered all this with a team of person, we sent this letter, he sent me back, and after I think that is possible today, really, about with how much items we have to take care of the people in distances, with the very long distances. And this is much better than before. There are many items. Sanitary items, I don't know. And after, the second thing that we did was to speak with people that was around the world. We make a team together. We were every day, we change our opinion for the weeks. It was the first period of pandemia, was very interesting. And we are start to understand what we can do in post-COVID house. What is an house? What is an apartment? The flexibility of an apartment has to be more flexible. We cannot have a big space, a small space. We can have it, we have to share, to organize this. And this is something good, not only for COVID period, post-COVID, is good to think for another flexible space. We started housing in a few years ago for a project in Barcelona, It was very flexible housing. And after we rediscovered what we want to do in that time, in these years, in these 2 years, we discovered that it's something that we can do. And now we are working this even in now.
And do you feel that these requirements come also from those that you are designing for? For example, are they saying that I'm designing this public building, but I want it to be flexible, and in case we need to shut something and change the flows of people, it should be flexible. Do you feel that there is this kind of need from the market that drives this?
I don't know the market. I don't want to know. Sorry. But I think the people need more flexibility, a more fluid, liquid space. This is something that I am quite convinced. The fluidity of the space, the real possibility to change, to. Another thing that we were thinking in that time was to have one floor or one condominium floor. In this floor, you can have many activities for all the young people, for something that you can use the more technology system, and after the young and the old can share different experience. And this is, can be a place where you can have inside even the place that you can make sport inside, in gymnastic, open it there, or can have a meeting with other people, I can make party. Inside of a condominium, one ground floor, or one top floor, so you can have, there are many activities for all the people. And then you are not more isolated. You start again to share your experience with others. This is something post-pandemic, as we were thinking that time.
Do I get correctly that this is the spaces for people to come back together?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I ask a little bit? Now, we lived like in an age of information, yes? Everyone says, oh, we have so many...
Even information.
Sorry?
Disinformation, not information.
Yeah.
Both.
Yeah, but and we have such a huge amount of information, yes, and sometimes I think, especially maybe the younger generation, like they do not value information so much because it's really very hard to collect what is the truth and what is false, and maybe sometimes they much more appreciate experience. And as you were talking about those spaces where the just flexible spaces and you actually can have an experience, different kind of experiences, maybe that's the future, that's the focus that we need to go and move forward, like this an actual experience.
Well, I think that it was the main is never changing. One man of 200 years ago, a man of 200 years after us will be the same. This he looks really, but the man is always the same. He's always a very small person with a very great idea, very fantastic emotion, with a very low emotion, with a very happiness and very darkness. Everything is in the man. And the man cannot change. We have seen, can have more information, but he's always the same. We need love, we need some people that help us, we help some people, we have some family, we don't want a family, we make crisis. Christ is always the same. It's a dramatic way to live. It's very difficult, the life. But it's very crazy, fantastic. And I love the life.
Thank you.
I believe students are also asking questions about what other architects inspire you, and there are few questions regarding, can you recommend any journals or book to read and things like that. So I'm just combining all of those into one. Any tips for future architects, and what do you like and would recommend?
It's very interesting. The only thing is, if they want to be an architect, they have never read the book of an architect. If they want to be an architect. If you want to do cinema, you have not to go to see cinema. If you want to be a sculptor, you have not to do the sculpture of the others. But if you want to make cinema, you can read books of people that are writing something different, crazy or normal. Or if you want to, you have never to use architecture to do architecture. If you want to do architecture, you use everything. So you go in the cinema. I cannot tell you because I cannot show you all the projects, but there is some project that came directly from the cinema. One project is the tower in Vienna. Perhaps you don't know, there are two towers, the Queen and Vienna. This came directly from Kubrick, from Odissea dello Spazio, Space Odyssey 2000, Kubrick. You say, well, one day that we meet, I tell you, or Wim Wenders movie of, can tell you where, or the book that you have to read, if you want to be good architect, you have to read the interview of the Truffaut of Hitchcock. I repeat, the Truffaut interview of Hitchcock. This is the product of the Ferrari project. No, I tell you why. Because he's in this interview, Hitchcock says something very important. He say that is the way he never tarred, how do you say, girare, tarred. He never tarred in interior, in outside, he make always an interior, in the studios. You know, he won't have always the same light. And after, with the same light, he could use the different system of montage. Can you understand montage? Cut and put together of film, when you cut, you took. Then there is one, I tell you something, after that, forget this. There is one Hitchcock movie, the name is Marni, one movie. Do you remember Marni?
I haven't seen it personally.
You go more to the cinema. I read the less architecture, watch less architects. Then this is fantastic because you have a Marni, you have the camera very high. They show something that looks like harbor. Was Baltimora in the mind of Hitchcock. And after stop one taxi, open the door, he was looking up one apartment, and after Leigh Marni, his husband, they are just in front of this apartment. And after the mother where opened the door, they are inside. Then all this is the way to give it to the architect. It's architect for me. It's the project, why I tell you the project of Ferrari, because you are outside of Ferrari, you have a script, I say, I want to come inside, come, I see up, and after I see there, I look at the water, and after there is a trees. What I want to say, to tell. This is all adapter. Before, when you arrive, you are cantilever, you come inside, you are open space, you are in the garden, there is tree. There is all this system to cut and to put together. It's a system that I use in architecture since 30 years, 40 years. But I never tell this. It is a forget this, which I never tell you again.
Okay.
Great. My own secret.
All right. I will choose some more questions, colleague, please.
Yeah, actually, I don't know. Now, it seems that all architectural things now happened in China. At least last decade, all new projects only in China. What happens? Also, you have some clients in China, and what happens? Do they understand new architecture very well, or just maybe they have a lot of money, or maybe they have obsession for good architecture?
There is one why, if you want to build something huge, important, there is only one country now, China. If you want to go small, nice, interesting, you have Europe is fantastic. But if you want to do really the experiment of the dimension, how much you can stretch the project that the Chinese, the client are like a client. The client in the world are all the same. There are no mythos of client. They are not genial or idiot. They are client. And then sometimes take a lot of time. We have a museum in Beijing that we are is doing, but is very, very slowly. Or there are some projects like airport was very fast. Or there are the two last they show you that an air complex of 250,000 square meters that we have finished now. I didn't show you, but it's if you want to make a, if you want to deal with yourself about the dimension, this can be because we have another project that we want to do. I want to do the density. I want to do a project that was a maximum density in the food in Shenzhen, in the boundary of Shenzhen. But this is an experience. The client is, if you have a client in the United States, is a client of the United States. It's always a client. But we did a Los Angeles project, very important project in Los Angeles. Was fast, hard, and with all the details, sometimes we fight to have a better quality of material, something like this, but it's always the same. I have noticed we have since 12 years or 14 years we are working in China. Wow, it's like in France we have office with about 30 years that we have office in Paris. We are building building one hotel in Côte d'Azur Cap d'Ail, Monte Carlo, and the other one is one school, small school, 10,000 square meters in Marseille. But it's always, for me, there is no very huge project with a small one. It's always one experience, a different experience, and after we go on.
Speaking of clients, I think one question is really interesting. Would you like any of your buildings rebuilt or destroyed? Or maybe you feel that it's...
the next one.
Sorry?
The next one. I love the next one.
Yeah, but you love the next one.
The past is the past. You cannot... Okay. The architecture is the art of forgot, forgive, for Dimitare, forgotten. Yeah. Forget is the art of forgetting. This architecture. If you today, you remember what you built yesterday, you do always the same project. If you want to investigate, go on in something, you have to forget. The day, today is another day, tomorrow is another day. But this is fantastic. Otherwise, you are quite crazy. You live the same day, the same sensation, the same atmosphere of the same day. I want every day, I want to find something new for me, to give a better life. For me, better life, if every day you have something new to do. If you have nothing to do new, it's very, very boring.
So you don't linger in the past.
No, I don't swim in the past. I swim
forward. All right. Come on. Any more questions from you guys?
I still think about, you mentioned in one place about the super mall in Germany. I think you showed the project super mall in Germany, and you said it's not like an usual super mall, but it's more like the landscape. So architecture as a sculpture or architecture as a landscape, because architects create spaces and we live in them. So how we can shape that landscape?
But it's if I want to have an inspiration, I look some landscape, something that I love now in this period is how can you tell you something that is a microbiotic, not at all with the COVID, la microbiologia, yes. Microbiology. If you see the way which they are going, come inside, they are coming, they are getting one with another, it's fantastic. This is nature, this is something else, that is better to investigate this. The duration, because I have seen a sculpture of a friend of mine that is coming really from, it's a molecular, it's fantastic. It's a fantastic project. It's a good inspiration. Perhaps I never will do this, but perhaps I will do it will be something else.
So nature basically is your source of inspiration. And even I think that parametric design you mentioned, how it can grow from one cell, starting from one cell, actually it also comes from nature, like the fractals and all those ideas.
Is an algorithm, a parametric we use is like nature. We say it's mathematical. Some point that mathematica is not physics, it's mathematics. If you put together physics and mathematics, it's interesting to see what happened. Now he said, I think it is, we are in different field, in different shape.
So I'd like to wrap up our discussion with the question, you know, one day maybe the pandemic will end and you will be able to travel to Lithuania. What would you like maybe to do here and maybe to meet the students, maybe to test?
Like my friend say, I did a project, but I never built. It was not what I have seen a few days ago, a few of these projects. It's not all perfect, but there are something that could be good. And I think that I want to build in Lithuania. No, not many projects, one project, even small. But there's something that I will be proud of, like my passport. That now I have my passport and now I want my small building.
Okay, so we need to look for ideas and make a proposition for the
the next, this is go and work for me. Thank you. No, thank you very much. Sorry.
Okay, thank you very much, Massimiliano, for this warm and interesting discussion. We still have a few questions here, but I'm sure these will be answered.
Maybe before, maybe it's another one, not two, one.
One, okay. What is your pleasure outside architecture? What do you like to do besides art?
When I walk in my city, in Roma, it was many years ago, I was thinking, where came from all this concept, this idea? And after 3 years ago, I discovered it's Roma. I built always the same project. It was my city. Because what is my city? It's narrow, after there is big piazza. And after you go up, you see the sky, you see all the skyline, but it's not narrow. And after it's big, baroque, something like that. And after compression and opening, this, I build always the same building, it's a Roma. Yeah, I'm a really stupid guy.
Right.
I discovered when I was 70 years old, that I did always the same project. I was thinking to do project completely different.
Yeah, I think that's a really good ending for our chat. So
thank you very much.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Everybody in Kaunas and Vilnius.
Greetings. Okay. Thank you, colleagues.
Thank you very much.
See you in Lithuania.